For over a decade, PLA has been the industry's favorite material, but always with one major limitation. It couldn't handle the heat. Until now. Introducing HT-PLA, a high temperature PLA that softens above 130 degrees C straight off the print bed. No post-processing, no extra steps. Thermal performance that rivals and even surpasses PETG, ABS, and PC. And the best part, it's still PLA. So you can expect all the printing characteristics and ease of use that you already love about PLA. Fine details, steep overhangs, long bridges, low sensitivity to moisture, not a problem for HT-PLA. I've 3D printed some flags in different materials to demonstrate the heat stability of HT-PLA. Let's do a live demo while I film this video, pop these in the oven set to 200 degrees C. Currently, our temperature inside is 206. I've drilled a small hole in the back of the oven so we can insert this probe thermometer and check the actual temperature of this cheap desktop oven. Currently, we're at 178 after just opening the door. There's a general rule of thumb with 3D printing materials that as the thermal properties increase, so do other negative side effects. PETG can be stringy, ABS stinks and warps, PC needs an enclosure, nylon's moisture sensitive. HT-PLA bucks this trend by offering outstanding printing characteristics using generic PLA printing settings, delivering perfect print quality and compatibility with every single extrusion-based 3D printer on the market. This means that if your business or home setup is already geared towards printing PLA, but you want a little bit more out of your material without sacrificing print quality or ease of use, then HT-PLA is for you. If you're having issues with heat stability, such as 3D prints that are deforming when shipping in hot regions, or a plant pot on a sunny window ledge, or maybe you want to print some accessories for your kitchen that can survive in the dishwasher. We're launching HT-PLA in 10 solid colors, along with 4 vibrant gradient colors, giving makers, engineers, and designers more creative control when printing parts that can withstand the heat. Along with HT-PLA, we're also launching a second material called HT-PLA-GF, a glass fiber reinforced version for extreme stiffness and dimensional accuracy. The GF version prints beautifully using generic PLA settings and is launching with 5 regular colors along with a special power tool color family, starting with 4 colors, which are perfect for printing accessories for your power tools and cleaning up your workshop. The GF version has been optimized for annealing, which unlocks mechanical properties that outperform ABS, with nearly twice the tensile strength and stiffness to match the thermal properties that are inherent to the material. Thanks to its glass fibers, 3D printed parts stay dimensionally stable during annealing. No shrinkage, no warping. I said earlier that you get 130 degrees C straight off the bed, and with both HT-PLA and HT-PLA-GF, that's true, but there is a catch. When the parts are stressed under heat and load, the mechanical properties are significantly affected. This is completely normal for all plastics, as the more stress a part is under, the less heat it can take. This is why on all Polymaker technical data sheets, we run a HDT test at 2 different loads, as well as a VCAT softening test, which is a measure only of the softening point. Let's have a look in the oven now. See if we can take out our test. Oh dear. If we speed up the footage from the oven flag test, we can see that while the HT-PLA flag is the last one standing, the flagpole has slightly deformed during the oven test. If we have a look at the balance point on one of these flags, we can see that the majority of the mass is the flag itself. So the load on the flagpole during the test is quite significant, which leads to the deformation seen here. If we run the test again, but move the flagpole to the center, so the load is much more evenly distributed, then we can see the HT-PLA flag stand straight and performs extremely well in the 200 degree C oven. This effect is what we call heat stability. It's the ability of a 3D printed part to remain dimensionally stable at elevated temperatures under minimal external load other than the part's own weight. On our TDS, this is measured as the VCAT softening temperature, the point at which a material softens due to heat. To achieve heat resistance, which can be defined as the ability to withstand mechanical stress at elevated temperatures with minimal deformation, this requires an annealing process to unlock the mechanical properties and bring them up to par with the thermal properties that are already within the material. This allows HT-PLA-GF to operate in scenarios where load and heat act simultaneously. And if we rerun our original oven test and introduce an annealed HT-PLA-GF flag, we can better understand the performance, as the flag is left standing without deformation. You might be thinking now, well, I can anneal regular PLA to boost the heat resistance, and you'd be right. And that's a strategy that all other HT-PLAs currently on the market take. But what happens with those materials is that during the annealing process, 3D printed parts warp and deform, making them useless for functional applications. It's here where HT-PLA-GF shines, because the glass fibers help stabilize the dimensions of your part throughout the annealing process. To demonstrate this, I've printed these two identical drill housings that were printed on the same printer with the same file using standard PLA settings. As you can see, the support removal is extremely easy and perhaps even better than the regular PLA. When we anneal the parts in the oven for 30 minutes at 100 degrees C, we can see the regular PLA housing deforming during the process. Once they've cooled down, it's clear to see massive gaps in the seam lines, making the reassembly of this drill housing impossible. If we compare this to the HT-PLA-GF housings, we can see a very clean seam line as the two halves snap perfectly back together. If you've never annealed parts before, let me run you through the process quickly. Simply put the parts in a preheated oven at 100 degrees C for 30 minutes and set them aside to cool down at room temperature after time's up. Alternatively, you can pop them in a pan of boiling water and simmer for half an hour. If you live in an area with hard water though, it's likely that your parts will end up looking a bit washed out from the calcium in the water. HT-PLA is still a PLA at its core. That means bio-based and more sustainable than traditional oil-based polymers. With its temperature capabilities, it has the power to elevate PLA from a consumer material to an engineering-grade filament. 10 years ago, Polymaker revolutionized PLA with Polymax PLA, the first tough PLA on the market. Now, a decade on, we've solved the final limitation for PLA by hurdling the last barrier that held back our favorite 3D printing filament.